night, beneath the starry sky. Nice work if you can get it, you can get it if you try. Strolling with the one girl, side by side. Nice work if you can get it if you try. Just imagine someone waiting at the cottage door. Where you ought to come one who could ask for anything more. Holding with the wonder and then taking it down. Nice work, you can get it, you can get it. Won't you tell me how?
Make your way to your seats as quickly as you can. All right, if I can have your attention, I'd like to welcome you to Delview's 2017, and I might add Delview's 10th commencement exercises. Would you please rise for the procession of this year's graduating class? Good evening, parents, grandparents, friends, and honored guests. Before we begin our ceremonies tonight, I would like to acknowledge the traditional territory of the Tawasin and Musqueam First Nations, as well as all the Coast Salish nations who have sustained and preserved this land from time immemorial. I'd also like to offer my respect to all the elders who've gone before us and to any elders and First Nations who are with us tonight. Would you please rise again for the singing now of our national anthem, which will be led by Hannah Baker, one of tonight's graduates.
Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all thy sons commands. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true north strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
All right, you may be seated. All right, settle down. To begin tonight's proceedings, I'd like to invite a few honored guests to say a few words tonight. I'm going to introduce you all at the same time and just invite you to come one after the other. So I'd like to welcome, first of all, Dale Sape to bring greetings on behalf of the Board of School Trustees, followed by Mr. Brad Bauman, our assistant superintendent, and following that, we'll hear from Ms. Morgan Kyle, our principal, who will give her charge to the graduating class. Mr. Sape, please.
Good evening, Principal Kyle, teachers, staff, and very warm and happy grads. It's my pleasure to be here tonight and to bring greetings on behalf of the Board of Trustees. You've come a long way in the last 13 years, but not without a lot of help from a great number of people. Your teachers, the support staff here, but most importantly, your parents and your families. And I'd ask that as you go forward in the next few days and celebrate this occasion, you show them respect and play safe. I wear another hat in my life, one of them being the chairperson of the Greater Vancouver Food Bank Society. And Delview Thanks for Giving is very well known across Canada for a very, well, and actually an incredible effort and a group of students that have a legacy here in this community that I don't think is matched anywhere else in Canada. So on behalf of the greater good of the community, I want to say thank you very much for that and what you're leaving behind for the students that follow. I would also like to thank the parents who have brought about such great behavior and such a great group of kids. I'm told that this is an exceptional group of children who have grown into adulthood with a caring for one another that is not often seen in a graduating class. So, on behalf of the Board of Trustees and on behalf of myself, I want to say congratulations and God bless. Thanks.
Well, good evening, everyone. Good evening, parents, staff, honored guests, and of course, the graduating class of 2017. It is my pleasure and honor to address you tonight and to bring you greetings and congratulations on behalf of our district leadership team. Tonight, we celebrate and acknowledge your hard work and accomplishments and the successful completion of your high school years. Give yourselves a round of applause. To the parents and family members here this evening, thank you for the unconditional love and support you have provided to your children over the years. Also, thank you for the partnership with the Delview staff and for trusting us each day with the education of your child. To Ms. Kyle and to all the teachers and support staff at Delview, thank you for your unwavering dedication and commitment to this impressive group of young people. Thank you for the guidance, encouragement, and caring that you've provided while pushing them to be their best. Please remember how incredibly important your work is and the difference that you make in the lives of Delta students. On behalf of our district team, thank you to all of you for what you do. And to the graduates, congratulations on all your hard work and your perseverance and your accomplishments. As you go forward, remember the important lessons you have learned through your high school years. These are the life lessons that reside in you, the important values such as self-respect, caring for others, acceptance, and what I've seen from Delview, caring for your community. The values that are your parents and your schooling are the foundation of who you are and who you will become as an adult. No matter where you are in the process of designing your plans for the future, always be mindful that the world around us is constantly changing. The qualities that we as educators hope to nurture in you must allow you to thrive in a rapidly changing world. In the Delta School District's bold vision, it states that we strive to be a leading district for innovative teaching and learner success. To this end, we've been committed to developing students who are able to learn and to think both critically and creatively, listen to diverse points of view, and appreciate a broad range of perspectives. Students who are able to communicate ideas in thoughtful and respectful ways and work collaboratively with teams and groups. Students who are able to adapt and thrive on change, becoming motivated, flexible, and curious lifelong learners. Ultimately, we aim to develop active, healthy, and productive citizens that care deeply about our community, our country, and our world. Many of you here tonight exemplify these characteristics, and you should all be very proud of everything you have achieved. Go confidently, graduates, in remembering that you have within you the strength, patience, and courage to reach your goals and accomplish whatever you set out to do. Delview Class of 2017, it is my sincere honor to share this evening with you. Congratulations on your graduation, and best wishes for continued success in the future. Thank you.
Good evening, parents, grandparents, sisters, brothers, friends, Delview staff, and guests, but more importantly, good evening to our grads of 2017. Before I get into my address to the grads, I have an important task to take care of. For those of you that know, I am from Saskatchewan, and I am a proud Saskatchewan Rough Rider fan. And Dale understands, he's also from Saskatchewan. And to give a sense of the kids that we've got this year, our grad pranks were thoughtful, they were creative, and in good spirit. Most of them. Well, no, all of them. All of them when it comes down to it. And one day I walked into my office and my office was full of orange and black balloons. All of my rider gear was taken out, and I have a lot of it. There was a BC Lions flag, there was a uniform, there was everything. And BC Lions are wonderful, but they're not the Saskatchewan Rough Riders. So the two that took a large part asked me to keep this. I've kept it for 3 months and had to look at it every day. So at the end of this, Cameron and Brandon, can you please pick it up? Because I need spot for my gnome. So it'll be available at the end of the ceremony. This night is about celebrating the long journey you have taken from kindergarten to grade 12. All of us here tonight share in the celebration with you. I'm sure I can speak for all of us when I say we are honored, truly honored to be at your side tonight. This year's graduation class has been inspiring, positive, talented, kind, humorous, and a wee bit frustrating, just like our own kids. You are our kids, and therefore you frustrate us. That is part of your role. But we also know you will excel in whatever you choose to pursue. We don't worry so much. This class embodies a sense of curiosity, passion, and conviction as individuals, but also as a collective. Always, always we noted that you supported one another on the sidelines, in the audience, in the hallways, in classrooms, and out in the community. This is what we remember from the class of 2017. This is your legacy to this school and to those that were in the younger grades. Curiosity, passion, conviction, and cohesion is what I want to focus on tonight. There are many who illustrate these traits, but two that stand out to me. You might have heard of them. Bono, of U2, and the late Steve Jobs. Both have been influential figures who have withstood the test of time. Neither graduated from college. Both have admitted to sleeping on floors and a variety of couches in their 20s. Why do I tell you this? Am I trying to inspire you towards mediocrity with the promise of wealth and fame? The promise of reward for bad or apathetic behavior on the evening of your graduation? No. The point is that Bono and Jobs' ability to think independently of mainstream social norms or the norms or paths of their friends, and they let their passionate curiosity with the world is and what has allowed them to be both become truly great and what's more, leave legacies that benefit others. Bono's passion has led him to Africa, where he's worked tirelessly for the poor, the sick, and the injured, but not for charity. He says, for justice. Jobs' similar inner nonconformist didn't see the value in his required coursework at college, but when he dropped out of the classes that didn't interest him, he dropped in to others that did. His intellectual curiosity led him to sit on a topography class of all things. It was this class, he claims, that inspired much of what he did with the first Mac computer. My challenge for you once you leave Delview is to think outside the proverbial box, as all great men and women do. What will move you with the same passion and intensity as Bono and Jobs have? Is it Syria? Climate change? Human rights? What box will you take the lid off of and flatten with your own sweat and moral capital? What will you be remembered for? Perhaps ironically it benefits us, this morbid fascination with all that is wrong with our world. Maybe it's a starting point with the problem that allows us to find the solution. Right now, the new hope is you. You are who the older generation is counting on, but someday, not too far along, you will gradually become old. Shockingly, I know, but you took Ms. Chow's biology class to know that. Your time is limited, so don't waste it living someone else's life. Don't be trapped by others' thinking. Don't let the noise of others' opinion drown out your own inner voice. And most importantly, have the courage to follow your heart, your intuition, and your moral compass. And if you haven't found them yet, keep looking. Don't settle. A trend among great people doing great things, which I think can be broken down into the following components. Be passionate. Listen to what it is that you really care about. Be curious. Don't follow the beaten path. If two roads diverge, take the one less traveled. Seize the day. Be motivated by the very short time we have here. Act independently, but do so for the benefit of others. Care for each other and not just yourself. Acknowledge the ugliness in the world, but don't live there. Focus on the beauty. Explore it, celebrate it, be part of creating it. Be self-reflective. It is the only way we truly learn. And don't forget to thank those in your life, whether they be your family, your friends, your teachers, EAs, our support staff here. Be gracious. It will take you far. On a personal note, I will miss you. Truly. I will miss your smiles, your graciousness, your pride of being a Raider, your acting, your athletic endeavors, your love of life, and the music. You have left a resounding mark on me. I have learned with you and from you, and I thank you for allowing me to be part of your journey. Now finally, don't settle. Get out there. It can be a beautiful life. The choice is yours. Don't let it get away. My very best to you, grads of 2017.
Good evening again, and welcome to the portion of the evening for which you have all eagerly waited. My name is Denise Unrah, and I'm on staff here, and to my right is Jonathan Kung, who is also on staff here at Delview. And we would like to begin our introduction of the graduates tonight. But before we begin, I would like to give a few instructions to both the graduates as well as you, our esteemed guests. And while I do this, could I ask row one to make their way to Ms. Chow at this time, okay? First of all, proud parents and grandparents, sisters, brothers, uncles, aunts, all of you who care about these grads, let me assure you again that a professional photographer is present capturing each important graduate's special moment, so you don't have to move from your seat. Isn't that wonderful? An email will be sent to let you know when to pick up the resulting photos along with their official Dogwood certificate. So if you can again, if I can remind you again, just to stay in your seats. The graduates will also be returning to their seats via that middle aisle, so it's just really important to leave that walkway clear. Okay, and now at the risk of wearing my teacher hat just one more time this year, can I speak to everyone from graduates to families, friends, and staff? We are celebrating over 135 students this year. Not just your child, not just the one you came to see. And so we want to pay attention to the presentation of all the grads. So can I ask you to turn off your cell phones? Can I ask you to refrain from chatting with your neighbor? Can I ask you that if you really do need to step outside, that you do so quietly and again refrain from talking at the back doors? That way, every graduate gets their limelight and gets their moment of honor and their glory. Okay, graduates, remember that you'll be coming up row by row as practiced in rehearsal. Please pay attention to Ms. Goltz's signal. And when your name is called, please remember to stay glued to that first X right there until we've had a chance to tell everyone a little bit about you. And the photographer's gonna take your photo at the same time, so smile. Then you're going to move on to be congratulated by Ms. Kyle. And if you have received an award, you're going to remain standing on the second X, just to the right of Ms. Kyle, where the presenters will join you to present their awards and more subsequent photos will be taken. Okay. Finally, to everyone, each graduate tonight deserves their place in the spotlight. So I ask that you applaud for each and every one. We also ask that you remain in your seats until all the grads have been recognized. We appreciate that the auditorium is full, that the temperature is rising, and we have a lot of graduates to celebrate tonight, but we want each one to be honored. So can I ask that you not only stay until the end of the ceremony, but that you also save your biggest applause for our last graduate tonight to assure her that we have not fallen asleep or tired of the procession. All right? Okay, then let's begin, Mr. Kahn.
All right. Noah Ahmed. Noah leads the class tonight, and how fitting. He has been a leader in his volunteer work with special needs children, as well as on the ice with his hockey team. He maintains his connections with his elementary school, Gibson Elementary, and Carrie Hyde and Razia Khan are pleased to present him with the Gibson Elementary bursary for $400. He is also the recipient of the first of two North Delta Minor Hockey Scholarships for $750. Thanks, Noah, for all the ways you've contributed to your school and the community.
Caleb Amaral. Caleb will forever be remembered for his commanding presence in the Patty Hillman Theater, where he not only directed and acted, he wrote and co-directed an original full-length play. He hopes to hone his play and screenwriting skills at Vancouver Film School next year. We look forward to seeing your name on the credits one day soon, Caleb, and hope the dream of an Oscar and a Tony are not beyond your grasp. Throughout the evening, you will hear us announce students receiving a district authority scholarship. There are 14 of those being given tonight. These scholarships recognize students who have excelled with outstanding achievements in a chosen focus area. And each of these scholarships is worth $1,250. Caleb is the first recipient of a district scholarship tonight for her achievements, for his achievements in fine arts. Mr. Annandale is presenting the award.
Simmer Anand. Simmer is a student with interests and talents she has used to benefit the Delview school community, from her tutoring help in media arts to her involvement in committees and events. To help her on her way to SFU, John Kim, the Law 12 teacher, is pleased to present her with the Delview Humanities Bursary for $300 given to a Law 12 student who has excelled in the course. Lorna Gordon and Winona Murray are here and pleased to present you, to present you with a $500 Margarita Award from the PEO Sisterhood, a philanthropic education organization that seeks to advance education for women around the world. You're a deserving recipient, Simmer. Congratulations.
Kayla Anderson. If you have had the delight of knowing Kayla, you know her pink iPhone is not far from her, perhaps under that deceptive black gown. But with a no-nonsense approach to life, Kayla has cheerfully and consistently worked her way through high school. And now she's Alberta bound, where she hopes to study to earn an LPN license. All the best to you, Kayla.
Montana Ackwing. Montana branched out this year and joined the theater cast for Delview's main production and wowed us all with her performance. She's planning to study massage therapy next year. To give you a head start, Devon Gardens Elementary is happy to present you with their bursary for $250. All the best, Montana.
Rasavo Ajla. Rasavo has pondered his many potential options because he's a man of many interests. He told me at one point in the semester that he'd like a book recommendation, but that it had better be good because he had no time to waste on a bad one. We know you will do well as you study to become a dentist, and your dreams of offering your services to children in the developing world is a noble one. Hold on to those ideals, Rasavo, and you will be successful. Tonight, Eliza Olson is here to present the $500 Ravi Kalan Scholarship to Rasavo. The award is given to a graduate who supports social justice and democratic ideals and who is involved in volunteer work in the community or school aiming to create positive change. Congratulations.
Taryn Badiouk. Taryn is a caring and kind young lady that has overcome a great deal of adversity to cross the stage today. Her kindness and concern for others while facing personal adversity has been inspiring. Congratulations, Taryn.
Hannah Baker. A girl with a silver tongue, the voice of an angel, and a heart of gold. Hannah is well-loved for her roles in Delview drama productions. She plans to take a year to work and save up for school, where she wants to study to become a drama teacher and inspire her students like she's been inspired by her teachers here. Well done, Hannah.
Shagun Bansal. Shagun's fondest memory of Delview was being dressed up and walking down the red carpet. Also related to that, we also discovered that night that he's quite good at cutting the rug, despite claiming that he didn't dance. Shagun says he's going to take the year off and also has a goal of becoming successful and rich. I'm hoping he's not being influenced by late night infomercials. Best of luck, Shagun.
Francesca Barada. Francesca with a flair is how I'd like to honor her tonight. Francesca has been an enthusiastic, keen learner and participant in whatever she has joined in at Delview these past few years. Her cheerful and energetic morning announcements woke many of us up during the morning lull this year. All the best to you, Francesca.
Kieran Leap Bariana. Kieran's fondest memories are all about breaking school rules and sneaking out of school without being caught by admin. Having said that, she wants to pursue a degree in criminology and work for the Canadian Border Services Agency and also make her parents really proud. I'm sure your experience will only help with your future plans. Don't forget to ask for a reference letter from Ms. Kyle, Kieran.
Gurjot Bassi. Gurjot is pursuing a business degree after high school and is planning to run his own business in the future. May all your plans be smoother than that one right there. Okay, congratulations.
Harjeet Baraj. Harjeet will always remember all her friends, old and new. She plans to go to college and expand on her education. She hopes to be happy and successful in life and to always have a fresh set of acrylic nails.
Sabrina Birdie. Sabrina would like to thank her family for sticking by her through this last year of high school. She would also like to thank her phone for sticking by her and never ever leaving her side. Congratulations.
Spencer Brand Louis. Spencer will never forget the friends he made. He currently has no plans for next year, but in his future, he can only dream of happiness. Spencer, Confucius said, if you want happiness for a year, inherit a fortune. If you want happiness for a lifetime, help someone else. I found that in a fortune cookie once, and now I pass that on to you.
Jenny Brar. A quiet and kind student, Jenny enjoyed Thanksgiving, the boat cruise, and the spring break trip to Eastern Europe. In fact, that trip infected her with the travel bug. And after she finishes her studies at SFU, she hopes to travel and be successful in whatever career she chooses. All the best to you, Jenny, and happy travels.
Brady Bromley. Brady's fondest memories are moments with his friends at events such as Thanksgiving. He will be going to SFU to study computer science, but only time will tell what he does after that. Having witnessed what he's capable of, we know Brady will invent his own way to success in whatever he does. Congratulations.
Cameron Burry. Cameron's fondest memories lie on the ball hockey court, where he discovered he was a natural leader. He plans to attend KPU next year, and in the future, I love this. He'd like to provide a happy home for his children the way his parents have provided for him and be happy. Worthy goals, Cameron. We hope that you reach them. All the best.
Orlando Calzada. Orlando had many memorable experiences in metalwork. We've seen some of his work, such as the T-Rex with the glowing eyes. Next year, he plans to work and study, and eventually he wants to become a police officer. Congratulations.
Amy Kennel. Amy already had a head start by completing high school early and working all of this last semester. She was such a positive influence on others when it came to any volunteering at school, especially with Thanks for Giving, and she will be really missed. Rock on, Amy.
Deborah Capilli. Deborah enjoyed creating memories that'll last a lifetime with friends she made here. She learned a lot in the past 5 years, which has impacted her life drastically. Next year, she will either go to KPU or CDI College. She then hopes to travel the world and either become a cop or a nurse. Congratulations.
Ricky Chand. It was no surprise to me when Ricky said that his treasured moments at Delview were walking around the halls. Sometimes he even found his way to his classes on time. He hopes to study at KPU and find a career to make enough money to be happy. All the best, Ricky.
Crystal Chen. Crystal has worked extremely hard at Delview to master the English language. She was always insightful when it comes to literature and drama, and also taught herself digital illustration in the last little while, creating many beautiful masterpieces. Delvey was lucky to have you. Good luck in the future.
Travis Plug. Travis is happy that he won beer pong in the library. He hopes to be verified on Instagram and Twitter. Not sure what that means. We are verifying your success, however, as a 2017 grad right now, Travis. Hope you find security and success in the future in real time as well.
Carson Conabert. Carson eats fish and chips with a fork and knife. Which is a great idea because otherwise you get your grease all over your hands, and who wants that? Carson, you should watch a film called The Straight Story about an old man who makes a long journey by tractor to mend a relationship with an ill brother. I know you can relate to journeys and tractors, but make sure you bring your box of tissues with you. Enjoy life, Carson.
Lindsay Cowdell. Lindsay divided her time between studies and a very demanding softball career. That softball has gained a scholarship to Douglas College for next year, where she'll be studying marketing when she's not playing softball. Lindsay is the recipient of our second District Authority Scholarship for her achievement in physical activity. She is also receiving a GNF Financial Group bursary for $500, an award given to an academically successful student continuing her studies in business. Rahina Talati is here to present the award, the GNF award. Congratulations and all the best, Lindsay.
Cameron Cunningham. Policing or drafting figure in Cameron's future, although he's undecided at this point. He's been a leader in his character throughout his years at Delview, both on and off sports courts and fields, demonstrating a willingness to help others succeed. And for this, Mr. Annandale is pleased to give him the Association of Delta School Administrator Scholarship for $750, as well as the Big Kahuna Scholarship for $250. He is also being recognized for his involvement in sports and service in his team and community with a Laura Zendre Endowment Memorial Scholarship, a KPU Entrance Award for $1,000. And Tana Steele is here to present the scholarship.
Utsav Data. Utsav didn't waste time letting the dust settle under his feet, making friends, playing basketball at lunchtime, being part of the recycling crew, and joining the yearbook team. Whew, that was a lot. He's planning to study pharmacy at KPU in the fall with hopes to travel the world and experience more that life has to offer. I'm sure that you will enjoy your life. Congratulations, Utsav.
Jaden Davis. No matter what his future aspirations, we know that Jaden loves rugby. I'm certain that Jaden will score in life as he did in high school. Nice try, Jaden. That's a rugby joke.
Raven Louis de la Cruz. RL is a quiet but dependable student, especially in his science and tech class. He's also probably the only Science 9 student to ever build his own electric motor for a project. Here's hoping that you continue to invent your own future, RL. All the best.
Zubair Dean. Zubair has fond memories of Thanksgiving and attending other school events with his friends. Next year, he plans on going to university, and eventually, he will find his way to becoming a dentist. That's why he's getting a certificate instead of a plaque right now, because he's not a dentist yet. A plaque. It's a dentist joke.
Nicole Dennis. A very courageous and multi-talented young prairie girl, Nicole was the first to sit for a student podcast this year, and you can hear part of her story on Delview's radio podcast. She's a jewelry maker, a photographer, a writer, and an aspiring teacher, with firm plans to move to Vancouver Island next year to bring her studies to become a teacher to fruition. She's receiving a little help with that tonight. Jessica LeBrun is awarding Nicole with the Delta Teachers Association Award for $900. Mr. Annandale is pleased to award her the Third District Authority Scholarship for Achievement in Indigenous Culture, as well as the Delta Youth Support Link Society Bursary for $500, awarded to a student who has displayed personal growth and self-motivation. Congratulations, Nicole. You will inspire your students.
Gerlene Dhaliwal. Gerlene is quite happy to have left us a mural that will inspire students in the future. Next year, she will be attending KPU. She hopes to one day complete a PhD in psychology. Best of luck.
Varjot Dillon. Varjot says he is grateful to have been able to participate in Thanksgiving. His plans are to study on the Hill at SFU, hoping to find a career that will sustain him and keep him happy. All the best to you, Varjot.
Daryl Diaz. I've had the personal pleasure of working with Daryl this year on Student Council. He's an ambitious young man, having completed his level one millwright through the ACET program. He has an ambitious plan to use his trade in pursuing both business and political goals that will benefit the community. His impressive presentation has earned him the 4th District Authority Scholarship winner in the category of Applied Design, Skills, and Technology.
Nabila Doctor. Nabila has noble ambitions. In her words, to one day help a larger group of people, not for recognition, but to raise awareness and help those in need. In order to meet these goals, she plans to study mathematics at Simon Fraser University as a start. Tonight, though, she is being honored not for her skills in math, but for her achievement in fine arts, and she is the fourth of our District Authority Scholarship recipients tonight. Congratulations, Nabila.
Victoria Donald. Victoria has participated in Thanksgiving since grade 7. She will always remember her friends. Next year she will sleep, probably work, and maybe get more education. I hope you end up doing all of those, Victoria. In the future, she will become a zoologist or zookeeper so that she can help protect and look after the animals. Congratulations.
Gulnir Dosanjh. Gulnir says she enjoyed time spent with both her peers and her teachers. How nice. She's going to study business administration at Douglas College, hoping it will lead to a life of happiness. We hope so too, Gulnir.
Shania Dosanjh. Shania will remember T4G and the grad banquet. She is headed to university and future success in whatever she does. Awarded to a student who has demonstrated the most improved grade point average in grade 11 and 12, the Delview Staff Scholarship for $100 is given to Shania tonight. Keep learning and growing as a student, Shania.
Jaspreet Dule. Jaspreet wishes to thank her friends and family for a memorable 5 years and congratulates each of her fellow graduates tonight. Congratulations to you as well, Jaspreet.
Sunraj Palour. Hoping to enter BCIT's interior design program in the fall because of his discovery of a love of drafting at Delview. That's it. Congratulations, Sunraj.
Marie Faria. Marie enjoyed extending herself on the volleyball and basketball courts here at Delview. Studying in the sciences at KPU in the fall figure into her future plans. Congratulations, Marie.
Gurpreet Galan. Gurpreet is well known in the halls of Delview for involvement in community committees, fundraisers, and events. To honor her volunteer efforts, Frank Jarvis is here from the Rotary Club of North Delta to present her with a scholarship for $750. For the same reasons, she is the 6th District Authority Scholarship winner in the area of community service. Her plans next year are to study sciences at SFU, and she has been granted a $2,000 SFU Story Close to Home scholarship to help begin her post-secondary journey. We will miss your enthusiastic contributions to Delview, Gurpreet. Congratulations.
Segal Guerra. Segal has also enjoyed friends here at Delview and remembers T4G as a highlight during his time here. He simply wants to meet the goals he sets for himself and be successful. Good choices.
Chloe Garvey. Chloe did the ACET culinary program at VCC. I predict that there will be good food in her future. For now, just wrap anything in bacon. It'll be delicious. Congratulations.
Armand Gill. Armand would like to thank his parents, friends, and teachers who have helped him out throughout these 5 years. Pass it on, Armand.
Gurbaj Gill. Just like the Todd Rundgren song, Baj doesn't want to work, he just wants to bang on the drum all day. Follow your passions, Baj.
Sunny Gill. Sunny Gill is a soccer player and is also a huge Manchester United fan. That's okay. Hopefully, he will make use of those passions in the near future.
Joe Gray. Hey, Joe, now's the season to wear shorts. Like many other students, Joe did not write about his future plans, so I can only guess that at some point involves being on a beach somewhere. Hang loose, Joe.
Nina Graywall. Nina will always remember her time at Delview, all the wonderful teachers and students she will miss. Nina is going to study at University of the Fraser Valley next year for general studies. She's uncertain about her future, but we know it'll be a bright one. Congratulations, Nina.
Taj Graywall. Taj likes junk food. We're all wishing that you have a healthy and happy life after graduation, Taj. Congratulations.
Danilo Grignich. Well, this may not surprise you, but band, theater, infotech, you get it, entertainment is Danilo's idea of a good time. He's gonna take a year off, get a full-time job, and start back sometime around this time next year, which oddly enough, Danilo, did you know, is perfect. That'll be just in time to take holidays for the summer. Performance arts, video game design, or anything else that inspires him are options he's considering. All the best.
All right. Gerlene here. It is no surprise that Gerlene is enrolled in Human Connects program at Capilano University for September, because she has made a career out of soccer over her lifetime, playing, coaching, and contributing to the soccer community. It is also no surprise, therefore, that she is the 7th District Authority Scholarship winner. In addition, Tana Steele is pleased to present her with the Laura Zendre Memorial Award for $250 for her community involvement through sports. Congratulations, Gerlene.
Andrew Hughes. Andrew is a quiet, thoughtful guy. He doesn't say much, but when he does, it's always thoughtful and insightful. He was a big contributor to his school community, and he will be missed. Congratulations, Andrew.
Navjeet Hundle. Navjeet will always remember all the breaks during the school day when she laughed her tears out with her friends. She'll be attending Douglas College in the fall and strives to be independent and successful in whatever career she decides on. Knowing her, this will become a reality in the very near future. Congratulations, Navjeet.
Mohammed Iftikhar. Aircraft engineering at BCIT is Mohammed's program of choice next year. He has enjoyed his friends here at Delview, but in the future, he hopes to travel far and find new friends. The sky's the limit, Mohammed.
Jeevan Johal. Jeevan, the piano man, has been our resident Schroeder for the past 5 years. And although he is committed to a career in engineering, his love for the piano keeps his music dreams close at hand. For his involvement in school and community and his excellence as a student, Mr. Annandale here is here to present him with a North Delta Lions Club scholarship for $1,000. Play on, Jeevan. Marcus Jones. A passion for words and a love of new places will fuel Marcus's future. He hopes to use his creative writing talents to become a travel writer one day. The 8th District Authority Scholarship for Fine Arts is awarded to Marcus this evening. Happy travels, Marcus.
Kyla Jordan. Kyla plans to work for a bit and save money for a backpacking trip through Europe with her brother Cameron. Happy travels, Kyla.
Natasha Carpin. Calling Natasha a lover of languages is an understatement. She not only studied Japanese among other languages, but she courageously chose to study as an exchange student in Japan. One day she would like to visit many countries, meet new people, and explore new cultures. She hopes to become a bridge between cultures. She is receiving the 9th District Authority Scholarship in the area of international languages.
I really want to hear you say that, Mr. Kang.
Gambatane.
That's Japanese. Well done. I just wanted to hear him say that.
I wasn't gonna
Rajveer Kaur. Rajveer must be one of those very few students whose highlights include Delview's Christmas assemblies. I don't understand, Rajveer. Finding the good in everyone, however, and everything, will support her ambitious plans to enter SFU's Beatty School of Business in the fall. To help further those studies, Rajveer is receiving the Canadian Federation of University Women's Scholarship for $600 because of her steady academic achievement and her involvement in school activities.
Autumn Keddie. Autumn is one of those lucky grads who chose her career path long before her senior year even began. She's attending John Casablanca Institute to study makeup artistry with the hope of making a living as a special effects artist. She's getting help towards those studies through a Royal Canadian Legion Branch $1,000 bursary. Looking forward to seeing your work under the lights.
Braden Kehoe. Braden, aka Kid Trippy, is a fun-loving guy with a profound love of rap music. He has overcome a good deal of adversity to cross this stage today, so we congratulate you, Braden. You've made it.
Hamna Khan. Hamna had some great times at Delview with her friends. She'll be studying criminology at SFU and wants to eventually go to law school to become a lawyer. I'm looking forward to having someone translate the terms of service on all my online accounts. Go for it, Hamna.
Taranveer Karut. Taranveer has also been accepted into the SFU Beatty School of Business, which is not an easy feat. So congratulations to you, Taranveer.
Grace Cornder. Grace had a memorable time playing on the girls' soccer team and making the Fraser Valley three times. She'll be studying psychology at Douglas College and will eventually become a counselor or a therapist. Congratulations.
Ashnita Kumar. Ashnita will finally remember seeing everyone grow and become who they are today. She is going to KPU for criminology in the fall and will complete a bachelor's degree in criminology to pursue a career as a border security officer. We'll see you at the border.
Bradley Lambert. This enterprising young man has enlivened our halls with his live at lunch guitar performances. He actually built his own guitar. So it's no wonder he's going to continue making and recording music around the world with his band while working as an apprentice welder. Bonnie Roberts, representing the Delview Pack, is here to present Bradley with a $500 scholarship for his positive attitude and great work ethic. Well deserved, Bradley.
Brittany Lawrence. Brittany is currently working in the restaurant industry and one day hopes to pursue a career in nursing. One of her favorite quotes is, "Sometimes you will never know the value of a moment until it becomes a memory." Brittany, value this moment right now because it's a good one. Congratulations.
Nikolai Lebedev. Next, Joe Lewis. Joe is a happy-go-lucky guy that will be sorely missed at Delview. He took the ACET program for carpentry and plans to join the family business. Joe seems destined to become a successful carpenter. I would be more sure if I saw his work, but Mr. Prideaux says he nailed it. Congrats, Joe.
Peter Lukacs. In short, Peter says he will remember his friends. He is taking criminology at KPU. There's going to be quite a contingency of you there. And hopes to become rich and famous. Hopefully, it won't take a zombie apocalypse for that dream to be realized.
Nikita Lukianov. Nikita has already had a taste of educational life outside of Delview, having completed a semester at BCIT, where he'll be returning in the fall. Congratulations, Nikita.
Nathan Mack. Nathan spends most of his days thinking about technology and will talk to you about his clever ideas until you're not sure what he's talking about. Thanks, Nathan, for all your help in the computer lab. Mr. Kung is trying to tell you that. And for your hard work on our Truth and Reconciliation Days. Thank you. Carmen McLeod. Grateful is the word Carmen chose for tonight. Grateful for friends, family, for grad events that she's enjoyed, and for the teachers who've supported her through her years at Delview. Criminology is also in her cards, and she wants to be an outstanding police officer in the future. Mike Annandale is presenting Carmen with the second North Delta Minor Hockey Scholarship for $750 tonight in recognition of her contribution to the hockey community. Congratulations, Carmen.
Palak Madan. Palak spent her last year of high school here at Delview after completing most of her education in India. She had to face all the challenges of adapting to a new culture and a new way of doing school. May you find your success in the future.
Imtaj Mali. Criminology certainly is a popular choice this year, and Imtaj's is no exception. She is grateful for the events and opportunities to hang out with friends at Delview. All the best to you, Imtaj.
Mandeep Manla. Looks like our world will be a safe place with this year's grads. Mandeep is joining the students who will be studying criminology in the fall. She's receiving the Sunshine Hills Tennis Club Scholarship for $125. The scholarship is given to a deserving student who demonstrates sports development through coaching or officiating. Congratulations, Mandeep.
I'm just going to pause for a second and just say you are an outstanding audience. Thank you so much. Avneet Mangat. Avneet spent her last 2 years of high school at Delview experiencing her first dinner and dance at the Winter Gala. She is grateful for the support of family and teachers who have brought her to this place today. She will apply her preschool training to work with preschoolers this summer before beginning a Bachelor of Arts studies at SFU in the fall. Congratulations.
Hargis Mann. Just like Peter Pan, Hargis doesn't really want to grow up, and yet he has. Congratulations.
Vincent Massigan. Eating lunch has been a large, eating lunch has been a large priority for Vincent. He also dreams of seeing man go to Mars in his lifetime, and that mental illness will be treated with diligence. He'll be preparing his lunch to eat at Kwantlen Polytechnic in the fall, where he will continue his studies. Buon appetito, Vincent.
Alandra Matei. For a while, Alandra has been our go-to for singing the national anthem, and then she showed us that she was super talented, not only at the mic, but also on the stage as an actress in many of our theater productions. Alandra wants to study criminology and psychology and eventually become a family or civil lawyer so that she can help repair people and families. We wish you all the best and know that you will continue to hold on to your passions. Congratulations.
Solange McKenzie. Solange will be joining other Delview grads at Douglas next year in pursuit of a career that will bring her happiness. Is there a degree in happiness at Douglas, Mr. Kung? Seems many grads are heading there with this goal in mind. We wish you all the best.
Hannah Mears. Hannah is well known here at Delview for her athletic prowess and was named Delview's Female Athlete of the Year. Corey Hopkins is here to honor her academic achievements and commitment to extracurricular activities with Annieville Elementary's $250 bursary. Thanks for your contributions to our school, Hannah.
Anoopjeet Minhas. Trades and travel. It's as simple as that for Anoop. All the best to you.
Rashna Minhas. Rashna will be going to Douglas College for psychology, for starters. Then she wishes to travel the world, write travel books, write children's books, and or become a famous fashion photographer. It's exciting to have all of those as your future goals. For her commitment to this year's outstanding yearbook, she is receiving one of the Future Book Yearbook Awards for $400. Enough to start that first book project, maybe.
Arsal Munir. Not here tonight? Not here.
Melvin Nadu. According to most of his teachers, Melvin Nadu was very quiet and dedicated, to the point where we don't really know where he's going in the future. I'm sure he has something planned, he's just not going to tell you. Congratulations, Melvin.
Austin Naker. There's a fan. Austin is receiving the Delta Firefighters Charitable Society Award for $500 tonight, given to a student continuing his education in mechanical or trades. David Terpsma is here to present the award. Congratulations, Austin.
Jessica Knowles. Jessica was one of the tireless members of the yearbook team. Her creativity extends beyond graphic design, however, and her plans include the baking and pastry arts program at VCC in the fall, with hopes of someday opening her own bakery. To that end, Mr. Annandale is pleased to present her with Canuel Caterer's Venn Master Scholarship for $500, as well as the second Future Book Yearbook Award for $300. May your croissants be flaky and your squares be sweet.
Ashley Owen. I happen to know that Ashley is quite the wordsmith. She cites her world of books and shows as being rewarding, but these are her words. But her world of flesh and bones is the support she needed to graduate tonight. Well done. Well said, Ashley. Congratulations.
Megan Palazov. Megan will remember her volleyball and soccer days in high school. She'll be traveling the world and experiencing new adventures and people. There's no better education than that, Megan. Enjoy your adventure.
Angad Parmar. Angad still remembers the very first day he walked into Delview. The rest is history. He'll be studying at SFU and will eventually become a doctor and help people in the future. We need more people like you, Angad.
Elise Partington. Elise will always remember Thanksgiving at Delview. She was extremely helpful on the soccer team and with grad committee this year. She plans on continuing her education somewhere in the fall. Her ultimate goal is to have an attractive husband. Since opposites attract, she needs to find the negative to her positive, the north to her south. It's complicated. Good luck, Elise.
Aziz Patel. Aziz is also one of Delview's man of few words. His highlights included everything in grade 12. He will study accounting next year, and he hopes to be successful. Reasonable desires. Congratulations.
Angelo Pinillo Zuniga. Angelo played a lot of soccer and basketball at Delview. He hopes to join the RCMP in the future. This sounds like a very rough outline of a career plan. Best of luck, Angelo.
Nicholas Poshner. Nick fondly remembers the Italy-Greece school trip last year. He will attend BCIT in the fall and says he's looking forward to enjoying refreshing beverages with the boys once, of course, he reaches the age of 19, as long as he's matured.
Adam Pywell. Adam is grateful for the friends he's made during his years at Delview. His ambitions include studying computer engineering, way to go, and 3D printing at SFU in order to invent a 3D product that will change the world. We'll look forward to that, and to acknowledge his personal growth and self-motivated efforts, he is receiving the second Delta Youth Support Link Society bursary for $500. He was also this year's nominee for the Schulich Leader Scholarship, given to innovative students in the fields of science, technology, engineering, and math.
Armand Ray. Armand would like to thank his family, friends, and especially all of his teachers who have dedicated countless hours to helping him mature into the special human being that he is right now. He didn't write this, but we are sure he's thinking this right now. Best of luck on your future endeavors.
Natalie Ram. Natalie enjoyed spending time with her friends. She plans to study sports science at Douglas College and will have travel plans in the future. Congratulations, Natalie.
She is also the recipient of another of our district authority scholarships. Congratulations, Natalie. Ramneet Rana. Ramneet spent as much time as possible during her time at Delview either watching or playing a sport on Delview's field or in the Delview Dome. For all of her effort and enthusiasm, Nadia Schalk is presenting Ramneet with the Western Campus Sports Scholarship for $200, recognizing Ramneet as a hardworking team player who gives her best. Congratulations and good luck.
Chandra Raturi.
Oh. Alex Rice. Give him a few years, and Alex will be available to adjust whatever back and neck issues you have. He hopes to start at Douglas in the sports science program and eventually move on to prepare for a career in chiropractics. Have a cracking life, Alex.
Braden Roberts. Braden has just been recruited to the Fraser Valley University baseball team. Go Cascades! And congratulations to you, Braden.
Julia Roberts. Yes, you heard the name correctly. And Julia has lived up to her thespian name in spades over the years at Delview, regaling us with her fine theater performances. For all her contributions to our Delview community and activities, Julia is being honored with the Delta Scottsdale Lions Club Award for $600. Arnando Verde is here to present the award. Congratulations, Julia.
Brittany Robertson. For her tireless efforts on the soccer pitch, Brittany is the 11th District Scholarship Award winner. What exactly she will study at Langara is not yet clear to her, but what she will play, soccer, with the Langara women's team is. And Langara College has made sure of that by giving Brittany an entrance scholarship. Nadia Schalk is also pleased to present her with a Forte Physiotherapy Scholarship for $250 to help her further her studies. Go, Brittany, go.
Patrick Rue. This is what I know about Patrick. He is an earnest and conscientious, fine young man. He is going to be attending Douglas College in their Engineering Foundations program. I know you will do well, Patrick.
Deep Sani. Deep is another of Delview students with a number of outstanding talents. She's been a visual artist here and is awarded Mountain West Studios Visual Arts Award for $500 as a result. She's also been given the Teamster Local Union 31 Scholarship for $2,500 to help her on her way to fulfilling plans to become a doctor.
Arundeep Sahota. We're not sure how difficult this goal will be to reach, but Arundeep hopes to make more money than anyone else in his family. So you can share it with them, I'm assuming, Arundeep. Hopefully you'll find time for what you love most, surrounding yourself with your friends as well. Congratulations, Arundeep.
Ashvir Sandhu. Ashvir would like to say thank you to his teachers, friends, and family who have helped him through these 5 years. Congratulations.
Taranveer Saran. Taranveer has used sports as a platform to contribute to the Delta and Delview communities. Ms. Pooney is pleased to award Taranveer the Mali Family Bursary for $200 given to a student in good academic standing who is committed to community or school service. Congratulations, Taranveer.
Holden Sasaki. When he was not attending classes, Holden could be found in or around the media arts room working on his latest film, a passion he has discovered since coming to Delview a short 5 years ago. His presentation for the district scholarship in the area of fine arts generally and filmmaking specifically impressed the adjudicators, and he is the 12th Authority Scholarship winner tonight. See you in the credits someday, Holden.
Rajdeep Serra. Because he'd like to own his own company one day, Rajdeep is committed to earning a business degree at KPU. We wish you every success.
James Sherwood. James is extremely grateful to his parents, teachers, and administration for getting him to this point tonight. Congratulations, James.
Gersimer Shokar. An excellent example to follow. Gersimer's motto in life is to surround himself with people who make him happy. He's made a mark on the soccer pitch each of the 5 years here at Delview and knows he will need to study and learn something in order to survive in the world. May all your friends be positive ones.
Rajivan Sidhu. Rajivan came from Sands to play basketball here and successfully helped his team into the provincial championships in 2016. Best wishes for whatever you have planned in the future.
Harpreet Sidhu. One of the Brotherhood boys at Delview. Harpreet is going to study criminology at Kwantlen next year, and one day, listen carefully, Mom and Dad, he plans to buy a house for his parents. Are you recording this? Congratulations.
Swag Sims. Swag will always remember being in the band and going on band trips. She hopes to take courses for early childhood education and will eventually become an elementary school teacher. It's a noble profession that needs more people like you. Good luck, Swag.
Dayanara Sinclair. Day is known around here as one of Delview's artists. Walk the hallway past the library and you will see her visual art contribution to the school this year. Or you might go to Mr. Waldman's house and see the portrait she did of his son hanging on his home. Her true obsessions in particular are Disney and animation. She wants to actually work at the Disney store next year, and she dreams of seeing her name under the heading animators scroll across the screen for a successful Disney animated film. Because of her dedication and skill in fine arts, she is receiving the 13th District Authority Scholarship, as well as the third Delta Youth Support Link Society bursary for $500. In addition, she is receiving this year's CFIRE Award for $500, an award that honors an LA or LD student who has shown most improvement academically. Well done, Day.
Justin Smith. Since he didn't write anything for us to read, all I can say is cinderblock. Now go out there and be a good boy.
Brandon Spencer. For his untiring and enthusiastic contributions to this year's yearbook team, Mr. Annandale is presenting Brandon with the third Future Book Yearbook Award for $300. I might add, you were also very untiring in your help to me in English classes. Thank you. Well deserved, Brandon.
Nadia Syed. Nadia is a highly motivated student with a positive attitude and a great work ethic. It is therefore a great candidate for the second Delview Pack Award for $500. We're certain she'll continue with these attributes as she pursues a degree in biology, leading into a medical school in the future. Bonnie Roberts is here on behalf of Pack to present the award. Congratulations, Nadia.
Lazarus Taban. Lazarus is our budding writer of rap, rhymes, and stories in general. Many of us have enjoyed his performances both at Live at Lunch as well as the Coffee House and Fine Arts Nights, And when in doubt, the Media Arts Room was a good place to find Lazarus dreaming up a short film with his friends. Next year, we'll find Lazarus on Vancouver Island, continuing his pursuit of writing. Right on, Lazarus.
Comet Tang. Comet melted hearts this year, crooning in both Mandarin and Cantonese at various events. He will always remember the grad banquet and feeling the togetherness of the entire grad class. He also had a chance to give a speech about what he loved about Delview. Next year, he will be at Douglas College for General Science and then become an engineer or researcher before winning the Nobel Prize one day. Dream big, Comet.
Julia Taylor. Julia wowed us with her performance as an actor as well as a singer at this year's musical and credits Delview as the place where she grew up. All she wants is to make her family proud. But if she can catch up on sleep, those 8:30 classes were a little bit early, weren't they, Julia? Meet Oprah and then go to university, all her wishes will be fulfilled. Best of luck to you, Julia. Secretly, Julia, I hope that you take the time to share your writing with the world as well.
J.F. Akur. Jaya helped ELL students as a peer tutor and did a great job of that. Whatever she chooses to do in the future, we know that she will be someone who is there to help when needed. Congratulations.
Simran Tandy. Her fondest time at Delview was the grad banquet where she gave a very witty teacher roast, and I think many of the young men in math or pre-calc would like to remember her as their great math tutor this year as well. She will be attending UBC in the fall, and she really wants to travel the world in the future. Bon voyage, Simran.
Shagan Tiwari. I had the pleasure of working with Shagan as well for Delview Student Council. She was the president this year and has served the Delview community tirelessly during her 5 years here. To honor her contributions, Frank Jarvis is here to give her the second Rotary Club of North Delta scholarship for $750. Congratulations, Shagan.
Prabjeet Tour. Prabjeet is another one of Delview's quiet but outstanding students. Rick Hobbs is here on behalf of Home Life Benchmark Titus Realty to give Prabjeet a scholarship for $500 to help her in her post-secondary business studies. All the best to you, Prabjeet.
Elizabeth Trottier. Meet a Wee Club president, that would be Elizabeth. Drama junkie, Elizabeth. Performer at each Live at Lunch Coffee House Fine Arts Night, Elizabeth. Dedicated band member, Elizabeth. Need we say more to convince you that she is deserving of the Delvey Fine and Performing Arts Scholarship for $500, presented by Julie Johnson, as well as the last of the Delvey, the District Authority Scholarships. In addition, she is awarded the second $500 bursary from Delta Youth Support Link Society, given to a student who is self-motivated and involved in volunteer work. Congratulations, Elizabeth.
Prableen Uppel. Prableen credits her experiences at Delview, including the first day of school, field trips, and new friends, with helping her build self-esteem and confidence. Enough confidence to dream of becoming a lawyer one day. That and exploring new cuisines and all the places she hopes to travel in the future. It is clear you are a poised young woman ready to embrace the world. Congratulations, Prableen.
Manjeet Virk. Money says his fondest memory is right now. So let's all take a moment and help him soak it in. He will be attending Douglas College for Business Management and hopes to open some sort of business of his own one day. We know you will. Go for it, Manji.
Brittany Walker. Brittany is another one of Delview's fine, talented artists. She is off to study art at KPU and to apprentice with a tattoo artist in hopes of making a career of tattoo artistry. We'll look forward to seeing your work on the arms and legs around us. Congratulations.
Gurpreet Welku. Gurpreet will always remember meeting new people at Delview. He is attending KPU in the fall and wants to become rich shortly after. I don't know about you, but I don't remember the last person who was rich after going through a university degree program. Unless you meant rich with knowledge, which you certainly will be. Enjoy!
Shotaro Yagi. Shotaro came to us from Japan and will be spending time at home over the summer before returning to his studies at Langara in business and psychology. He loves to work out, so he intends to run his own gym one day. Stay tuned to see when he'll be able to pump you up. All the best to you, Shotaro. And now we have come to our very last graduating student. So you ready? Ready for the applause? Go ahead, Mr. Kang.
Cindy Yuen. Cindy Yuen worked very hard and always with a smile on her face. Cindy is always ready to lend a hand when needed. Congratulations on being a Delview graduate and the final student to cross the stage tonight.
And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen, the graduating class of 2017. At this time, we're not quite done. You have really been wonderful. Thank you so much for your attention and giving honor to all the grads. At this time, I'm going to ask Simar Anand to join us on the stage. Simar has been chosen as this year's valedictorian. She's a fine student who's been involved in many, many activities here at Delview, and she is really a very worthy candidate for this year's valedictorian. So we welcome you to the stage, Simar.
I would like to begin by welcoming distinguished guests, parents, staff, and the graduating class of 2017 to the auspicious occasion of our commencement this year. It is an honor to be here representing my fellow graduates of 2017 today. Now, let's begin by taking a walk down memory lane, shall we? We all first walked through the doors of Delview as talented yet timid individuals. We all had the same fears and the same excitement running through our veins. Sorry. We were all once from schools that once played as rivals at our school basketball and volleyball games. But these new people were the ones who would later become our best friends and acquaintances, who would tag alongside us during this five-year journey. From those first experiences, we can all agree that the past 5 years have been quite the learning curve, helping us all grow into the young, amazing adults we are today. Delview taught us how to become the best versions of ourselves, and we cannot be thankful enough to those who have made this possible. Dealing with the teenagers' ups and downs can be very difficult, to say the least, and I would like to thank all of our teachers and parents for this. So, teachers, thank you so much for moving those test dates, even when we'd rant about how underprepared we felt, usually just days before the test. And thank you for also giving us numerous extensions on our project that we just never seemed to complete on time. Thank you to our parents who have been there every step of the way. Even when our printers got jammed or ran out of ink, you did anything and everything you could to help us. Thank you for packing our lunches, driving us to school, paying for our school fees, and of course, listening to our explanations as to why the school called in to report an unexcused absence. We would also like to acknowledge our custodial and cafeteria staff. Thank you for keeping our school spotless. even when many of us forgot to wipe our juice off the floor or accidentally left our garbage all over the place. Thank you to the cafeteria staff for always having those fresh baked cookies. We can all agree that those were probably the best 80 cents we've spent on something. And thank you for always serving us with big smiles on your faces, no matter how long that cafeteria line was. Now, let's quickly rewind to grade 8, the tough transition that introduced us to newer challenges that we had yet to face. Simple tasks like opening our lockers and finding where room 181 was located, or even having to visit not one, but four classes felt arduous. But this was just the beginning of this wild journey we were about to embark on. Then came grade 9, the year we had fully come out of our little shells and began growing as Delview Raiders. We no longer felt like outsiders, and Delview became our second home. We knew where all of our classes were, basically knew everyone by face at Delview, and didn't have such a hard time adjusting to our new schedules. Finally came grade 10, and despite those gruesome provincials we had to write that year, we continued to grow and flourish within ourselves. Grade 11 came as a surprise to many of us. Harder classes, stress, and the burden of being seniors who must stand as role models for other grades. But we managed to handle all of that. And best of all, that year helped bring out our strengths and weaknesses, which we all benefited from. We quickly figured whether calculating velocity and momentum was in our best interests, or whether we liked to learn about the different phylums and kingdoms in biology, or neither. On the other hand, some of us discovered that drama and theater was our thing, and maybe others found math to be something they really enjoyed doing. But hey, at least many of us got our driver licenses that year. They turned out to be quite handy while making all those Starbucks and Tim Hortons runs this year, eh? But today, we are grade 12s, moments away from graduating. This year had its perks and difficulties too, but it's that one year that we will never forget. Grade 12 allowed us to become friends with everyone. It brought us together through things like grad committee meetings, boat crews, and other fun activities done throughout the year. And I need to mention the one place in this school that added to this entire experience, the one and the only grad room. Thank you for being our second home. Now, grads, I would like everyone to close their eyes for a minute and picture themselves walking the stage receiving their diplomas. This walk that we all just made is not us just walking across a stage to receive a diploma and kick it, but it is us making an entry into the real world. Each year, hundreds and hundreds of students make their way into the real world. This year, over 130 of us will be a part of those students. It's rather exciting to see how much potential, ideas, abilities, and amazing skills we all have. Like our amazing athletes, who work hard to make Delview very, very proud. Along with our ever so talented musicians and artists that have mesmerized us with all the talent that they had to offer. Not to mention those who have chosen to be in the ACIP programs and the gifted individuals who have excelled in all of their coursework. I must say, the future is extremely promising. John A. Shedd said that a ship in harbor is safe, but that isn't what ships are built for. And I would like all of us to remember that. Never keep your potential a secret from the world. Bring it out and conquer life. At last comes a time where I must inform you that many things we have relied on are about to end. We must become self-motivated and stay on track without much guidance. The world can be a very wonderful place from what we've seen, but it can also be a very difficult place too. But as an individual, always remember some key mottos to live by. Respect, keep safe, love, be loved, appreciate yourself and those around you, and most importantly, as cliche as it may sound, never give up. Because all of us have everything and anything it takes to become something that we will one day be very, very proud of. As Eleanor Roosevelt said, the future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. So grads, never give up dreaming and never stop working towards them. Grads of 2017, congratulations. Continue to smile and continue to thrive. Ladies and gentlemen, this was Simmer Anan on behalf of the entire grad class of 2017, now signing off. Okay, I would like to take this opportunity to call all grads of 2017 to the stage for our final hooray.
no, you're good. Okay, just before I give it over to Simmer to do the final hurrah, I just have a few words to close off the ceremonies. So first off, I'd like to remind everyone that at the conclusion of tonight's ceremonies, there will be refreshments served in the small gymnasium through the doors to your left. Also, a reminder to all graduates to please return your robes and stoles to our assistants in the hallway to your left between the gymnasiums before you depart tonight. So finally, our graduates, you've made it. Well done. Congratulations to all of you. You've worked hard to reach this milestone, and you should feel proud of your accomplishments. But don't forget to take the time to thank your family and friends who have helped support, mentor, and motivate you along the way. Now here you are, the end of high school. Yeah. There is much pride in reaching an end to something. It signifies that you've achieved your goal, that you have overcome any and all challenges and obstacles that may have been on your path. Being at an end gives you a chance to look back and reflect upon your journey, to take stock of friends and the adventures that you accumulated along the way, and to contemplate the lessons learned from the struggles and challenges encountered and conquered. So be sure to take some time to look back and reflect on your journey with pride. But the thing about endings is that they're also beginnings. They're time to look forward to what comes next. Now you have to make decisions about the direction for your next journey, your next challenge, your next adventure. And now you get to take stock of everything you've gained from the past, the friends, the adventures, the struggles, and the strength to get you through, and use them all to guide you going forward. I'm proud to wish you all the best for your future journeys, and I'm confident that the lessons learned and experiences gained here at Delview will guide you well. I challenge you to all take some time to reflect on the past, take some time to enjoy this moment and celebrate your accomplishments. And then take what you have learned and aspire for greatness as you set your course to the future. And never forget, once a Raider, always a Raider. And now I will turn it over to Simmer to do the final congratulations to the Delview grads of 2017.
Grads, it's time for us to move our tassels from right to left, and at the count of three, we'll be tossing our hats up as a final hurrah. Three, two, one.
Hang on.
You're not used to this stuff, but
I'm not.
Kyle Morgan, the exceptional job tonight, principal for the school. Did it go off like you expected tonight?
Yes, even the end, although it wasn't in the plans. What a great way to have a closing with Mr. Annandale doing it and all the kids around it. We've got an exceptional group and an exceptional group that's organized it, both kids and the adults. It couldn't have been any better.
A lot of time's taken by the students as well as the teachers to put this event on. It's something that doesn't come together. I mean, you're not gonna start it and have it finish overnight. It's a lot of time behind the scenes preparing for this.
The teachers that do this, well, not only teachers but our support staff, put in collectively a couple hundred hours. Absolutely, no question about it. It is a big event. It's an important event for our kids. And
when should we move everybody out of the way? We're fine. I love the way you were teasing the kids about the gnome.
Yes. Well, they know my Riders stuff, and you can never get enough converts to the Riders.
No kidding.
Go Riders.
Yeah, well, that's okay. Nothing wrong with that. And this is Raider country here too.
Yes, it is. Absolutely. Once a Raider, always a Raider.
No kidding. So what's next for the school going beyond this year?
Big things. And big things in the sense of, not hitting the papers, but like we have such an exceptional staff and we have such great kids and we're this kind of quiet little success story at Delview. We've got innovation going on. We've got kids that, have some pretty tough circumstances, but our staff just supports those kids along with their families and move them along and get them along when sometimes the kids don't think they can. So in my mind, that's a great part of Delview. It's a true community. Kids come back all the time. And we're proud of that.
Everything from the exchange students to even listening in to what the students want and they set their sights on for graduation. That's quite the remarkable feat for young kids, because a lot of people graduate, they said, I have no idea what I'm doing.
Yeah, and some of our kids that still don't know right now, that's okay. They're like 17 and 18 years old. And so we need to give them some time and they will blossom. But they've been given a really good foundation by their families and by our staff. They will thrive, no question in my mind. There's an exceptional group.
There's an awful lot about the exchange students as well.
Yeah, we've got this international core of kids that come, and because we're small and because we're a community, the kids look out for one another. Our staff kind of takes those kids under their wing, and our international students really thrive because we care about them, and they're not one of 1,400, they're one of 700, which is much easier to manage and move them along as well.
It also gives a lot of credit to our Delta School District and what all the trustees do.
Absolutely. Our trustees are really supportive of what we do in the buildings, and they kind of, put things in place. They support it both by being here, and they come out to different events, and they acknowledge and celebrate what are going on in our classrooms with teachers.
Very much, Kyle. Thanks very much for doing this. Congratulations on such a successful event, and looking forward to doing this next year. I already got some ideas as to how we can make this better for you next year.
Wonderful. We're always open to ideas.
Okay. Thanks, Kyle. Good luck, okay. And have a good summer.
Okay, you too. Thank you.
Thanks very much. Enjoyable evening. We'll go back upstairs to the sign up there, and then we'll sign off.